This is Sway.
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 In the morning.
In the morning.
In the morning.
Shake your body.
Wake your punk ass up.
Sway the morning, Shade 4-5, man. My young homie is here, man.
Yeah, yep.
Yo, you know, I'm home, Joey. Yeah, that's we here.
You know what I mean? Last time he come up here was, you know,
Dizzy Rat was here.
That's right, right?
Yeah, I crashed his segment. My bad, Dizzy. I apologize.
Nah, but that was kind of cool, though. I like that. Yeah. Just, you know, all improv, no script, you know. Man, I was just telling Heather and Tracy how proud I am of you, man, watching your growth, man, your elevation.
Yeah.
You know, Joey. At one point, Joey Fast was homeless not that long ago. Just 2 years ago.
That's not that long ago at all.
Damn, man. Being homeless, like, was you, like, sleeping on the street homeless?
I was sleeping in my 86 Camaro. I had an 86 Camaro T-top. Damn. It was, like, my dream car, so it was, like, a little relief, kind of. But still, though, you got a lot of, like, lonely nights. You know, you, yourself, and God sleeping in that shit. It's, like, super cold. It's an old-ass car, so when the metal get cold, it's like no heating yourself up. It's just like you got to deal with it. Hopefully you sleep by the time that metal get cold.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah, but
yo, that's some real.
Yeah, hug yourself.
Yeah, like, but like just touring Europe. Like when I did a Europe tour with Rocky in 2013, and going back to my car, it was just like,
wait, you went on tour and
I had Timber Jones 2 out. Like before I met Waka, I was homeless. Like before I met you, like my first time meeting you, like 2 months before that, I was homeless. Like I had Timber Jones 2 out. I had songs with A$AP Rocky, Danny Brown out, and I was homeless. Like, but that's how I gained the following, though, because I was just being transparent. Like, I wasn't the guy, like, to throw in a chain and try to, you know, pull on his facade, like, oh, my real name is Joey Virtue, but I'm Joey Fats right now, I'm getting money, da-da. It wasn't that. It's just more like, that's, like, if you listen to the music, it describes itself by events. Like, more like, you listen to my old music, like, from last year or anything 2 years ago, I'm talking about me being homeless a lot, you know what I mean? Me not having nothing, because that's what I was going through, you know what I mean? And you know, like, having Yams around, you know, he helped a lot, you know what I mean, mentally, like, you know what I mean? That was, like, you know, like, my safety net, you know what I mean? Like, when I was losing myself, he'd just be there, be like, bro, everything will be all right, you know what I mean? So, it was hard, but at the end of the day, like, it is what it is, man. It could be worse.
It could be worse. I like that, man. And Yams plays such an – we talked about this before, but Yams is so instrumental in so many people's lives and the trajectory of their career. So I know his loss is truly missed, but you're taking away those lessons, that right?
Yeah, I used to have, like, a lot of just, like, mind-picking, like, moments with him. Like, I lived with him for, like, a little bit, you know what I mean, like 6 months. Mm-hmm. When I was working on my project, Chipper Jones 2, I lived with him and Rocky for a little bit. And, like, every day I used to just wake up, and he used to be sitting Yoda style on the couch just on his laptop. And I used to always wonder, like, what the fuck is this dude doing 6 o'clock in the morning? But he's searching music that's coming out during the day. Like, he's looking at Sway, somebody who was on there the day before, you know what I mean? Like, he just always up to date. But, like when it came to, like, just real life, you know what I mean? Like, because he was homeless like me, you know what I mean? He used to sleep at the park. When he was putting Rocky on, like, it caught. Like, he had to pay for that raff Rocky was wearing. Like, you know what I mean? Like, he did that, you know what I mean? He was sleeping in parks for Rocky to look that way, you know what I mean? So
he was,
like, the person who understood me the most. That's why we were so close. Like, you know what I mean? I had my anger problems, but he just, like, he laughed. Like, bro, you tripping right now. Like, just calm down. Like, you know what I mean? Because he knew me.
Yeah.
He knew. He'd been there before, you know, like, being homeless, like, of course you're going to have some frustrations, you know what I mean? Because you feel shit can move, like, a lot faster.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So that's more like what it was, you know what I mean?
Well, so here's the thing. So I went outside to, you know, like, the homies, I'll go outside and greet them before they come on the show just because I'll be happy to see them. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I was happy to see you. And the first, you know, we started talking. I asked her, so what's been up with you? And then you revealed something that I think anybody listening right now could be inspired. Like, if you think you got it hard, you know, and you think you can't see what, you know, that light, or to be cliche, light at the end of the tunnel, or you can't see change coming in your life, listen to his story. He just told you he was homeless, sleeping in a Camaro, probably brushing his teeth, wiping his ass in that same Camaro.
Right. I was brushing teeth. I was waiting for the public bathrooms to open at the park.
Yeah.
I brush my teeth and wash my ass.
Did you ever take any girls, by the way, in a Camaro?
What?
Yeah.
Oh, hell yeah.
Okay,
you take them T-tops off their feet, sit right there. It's lit. What you mean?
My
God. He's lit.
Wow. Yo. So that was his house?
Yeah. What? They love the I-Rock. What you mean?
Oh, my God.
What you mean?
Yo,
what you mean? Probably even have a candle lit on the dashboard. What you know mean?
Playing your music in the background. All right. And it, but then you revealed to me recently that you just acquired something, right?
Yeah, I just bought a store across the street from the Staples Center.
There it is, man. Two years later, man.
Shit,
he's a business owner now.
I appreciate it. Yeah, I appreciate it. You know what I mean? But it's like people like you know what I mean? Who, like I was just listening to your segment earlier. Like, I heard something about, like, gangbanging and shit like that. You know what I mean? And, and like, if we like, let's use gangbanging in a metaphorical way in the rap game, okay? Mm-hmm. Like, the reason why gangbanging sucks now is because, like, the reason why it's watered down now is because, like, say I'm a rapper. Mm-hmm. When I first met you, you being an OG and you liking my aura, you feeling like what I was about, you told me the real, you know what I mean? And you was always transparent with me, you know what I mean? But, like, in the streets, it's not the same way like that. It used to be, like, when I first got put on 99, it was about that, you know what I mean? It was it was about that, you know what I mean? Like, it was about knowing what the bigger prize is. It was bigger than the streets, you know what I mean? It was a brotherhood. It was more like, say, for instance, like, all of us in this room wonder, can be broke, we go give him a quarter piece, you know what I mean? It ain't legal, but we go give him a quarter piece and we gonna make a bubble. He go get on his feet, do whatever he gotta do. It was a brotherhood, you know what I mean? And going back to just like the story and whole rap shit, just like when, like, I felt like, you know, when I lost Yams, you know what I mean, shit like that, like the moments I had with you on here was the shit that I thought about. Like, yo, Sway ain't just giving me his personal number, ain't texting me telling me, yo, how you doing, how, like, ain't doing this for no reason, you know what I mean? Like, I got something, you know what I mean? And that's more, like, more what it was. Like, it was, like, you know what I mean? I was saving money, you know what I mean? Putting shit aside and just really stacking. Like, not only that, I bought a $90,000 car, too. Like, I got an M6. Like, you know what I mean? Like, so.
What the hell?
Like, it's like.
You're living better than me now, man. You live from home.
Like, but, like it's just, like I'm saying, like, but you helped me do that, you know what I'm saying? Like, so, like, it just, bro, you motivated me, bro. It's, like. It's very few people, you know what I mean? Like, I feel like, you know, like I said, being transparent, I give credit when credit is due, you dig what I'm saying? And you helped me a lot, bro. Like, you know what I mean? Just, even just, bro, every day, every time you talk to me is eye contact, you know what I mean? I feel it. It's like, I believe in you. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I talk to him about it. Like, you know what I mean? Like, this dude, like, every time I come here, I'm nervous. Like, it's my first time. Like, I went to go take a shit before I came on. I ain't gonna even lie. I was nervous.
You ain't seen Tracy?
I was nervous.
Nah, they wouldn't let me go do my two, yo.
I was nervous. I'm like, but it's just the fact that I got so much respect for you and so much what you know what I mean, what you represent for the game, you know what I mean?
Thank
so
you,
it's
bro.
Just like.
Yeah, man. Hey, but you, man, I appreciate that. Hey, man, Joey, don't make me tear up on my own show, man. Fuck out of here, man. I'm hard. All right.
You're real, though.
From Oakland, stop.
Yeah.
But no, it is real. And when we do that, we don't do it for this moment, but I appreciate that.
Yeah.
And I'm inspired by you. So, you know, hearing your story, you know, I've been around a lot longer, you know, but you're going to constantly in life find people that's going to inspire you.
Yeah.
And I don't judge folks. I don't look at the cover. I don't know what, I don't care about their past. I know what it, you know, I got in my own past.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I know what I was able to get from it. But seeing your story and hearing you be so transparent, I know you're going to inspire other people coming up now. Other youth. That's why I want you on the show.
That's really what it's about, man.
Yeah,
like,
right.
I did, like, things in the street that's gonna guarantee I'm gonna burn in hell for eternity, you know what I mean? So it's just like I get thrill out of, like, that's my manager, he's 18 years old, like, you know what I mean? Like, he just graduated high school. I get a thrill out of giving kids and just people, like, you know what I mean, shit that they never seen before. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I got peripheral artery disease, like, you know what I mean? Like, my legs fall asleep when I've been, like, severe pain, you know what I mean? But
you got,
like,
that now?
Yeah. Like, I got bad health, bro. Like, for me sleeping, like, you got to think about it. So, I'm sleeping in my car. I don't have no refrigerator.
Yeah.
I don't have nothing. So, it was McDonald's every day.
Mm-hmm.
And that shit is horrible. Like, I went to the doctor. I had 26% body fat behind my abs. Not on the outside, like, flub, but it was behind my abs. It was unhealthy. He telling me, like, you borderline diabetic.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But it's just like... That's what the Farrakhan song is about.
That's
I woke up, man. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not Muslim. I'm not one religion, but, like, it's like Chief Keef.
Mm-hmm.
He puts out so much music, it's up to you to depict and listen to what's good and what's aight and what's, like, what you throw that away, you know what I mean? And same with Farrakhan. Like, he say a lot of shit that's just like, yo, this man is fucking crazy.
Yeah.
But he say a lot of shit that's true.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, how the county aid is crippling, you know what I mean, the black youth and the black, you know, blacks, period. You know what I mean? Because they're dependent on that $200 and them food stamps. You know what I mean? Take that away from them, they go get out and hustle their ass because they need to eat. You know what I'm saying? So, me just, you know, just doing a lot of studying, a lot of reading, you know what I mean? Just knowing what I'm up against, you know what I mean? Like, you got to know what you're up against, you know what I mean? Yeah. Living in America, and I just really, you know what I mean, learned the beast, you know what I mean? I learned it, and I feel like, you know what I mean, I know the key to life is not in riches, you know what I mean? I'm rich in soul, spirit, mind, you know what I mean?
So,
you know what I mean? I'm you know what I mean? I'm out this world, you know, with it. Like, everything could be taken away from me tomorrow, you know what I mean? Like, M6 and all that, but me being down where I was, like, I think I even enjoy life even much more if it was taken away from me. Like, I tell my manager all the time, like, life was much more enjoyable to me when I was homeless because the essence of everything. I even remember how shit smelled. Like, I used to go to a certain space and be like, yo, this shit smell like da-da-da-da, you know what I mean? Because I just appreciated life so much now, like, and back then, you know what I mean? But now it's just like, it's not that I don't appreciate it. It's just like, I'm not used to it. Like, you know what I mean? I'm a shy guy. I'm not used to attention or nothing like that, you know what I mean? I'm just, back then in the day, like, I got to provide for my people, you know? Yeah, I'm using the music as a stepping stone, you know what I mean, to broaden, for bigger, bigger audiences and shit like that to really do what I got to do. And, you know what I mean, like, that's like a lot of shit, a lot of people like misunderstand a lot of shit that me and Vince rap about, you know what I mean? Like, and they don't really understand, like, you know what I mean? Like the Senorita video, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And shit like that, like they think we just Crips, you know what I mean? Like, nah, like bro, like black, like Vince is raised up like on some Black Panther shit, you know what I mean? And me educating myself, waking up, you know what I mean? Like it's serious, bro. And it's just like, it's like America fear the most, like somebody who's articulated and good, book smart and good in the streets, like that can do both.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And that's what I always told myself, and that's what I'm trying to master right now.
Man, Joey Fats, ladies and gentlemen.
Fuck that shit.
Man, I got chills, man. I'm about to show off my t-shirt I just got from Audio Push yesterday, man.
Yo, shout out Audio Push. Shout out the IE one time.
You know what I mean? We're going to play this Farrakhan song, man, and I've been playing it back and back and back and back and back, you know, and it did, and I love the speech, you know, the fragments of some of the speeches that you incorporated in the song. Did you by any chance get, you know, did you talk to
Farrakhan?
Yeah.
I wish I can pick his brain. I think I'll be the one that scare him the most because I'm not here on some rapper shit. Like, I'm not here on no rapper shit. Like, I'm honestly interested in this man. Everything he's been through in history of America, like, he knows something. Mm-hmm. He knows a lot about America. And, like, to me, that's what it's about. Like, when I was homeless, like, that's what I learned about being homeless. You listen to, like, what everybody been through, something you ain't been through, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So I always listen to what everybody had to say. I'm talking about somebody who couldn't even benefit me, who was just homeless just like me. I even listen to him, you know what I mean? God put people through certain shit that you can't go through because you probably can't handle it. Like, it's a reason why certain people walk around with AIDS and cancer.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? To them, it's hard. But God is telling me, like, you can handle it. You got it. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
The reason why we don't got it, we probably break down being a bunch of bitches, like, soft as shit. Like, you know what I mean? Like. Mm-hmm. It's a reason, like, it's a reason behind everything, you know what I mean? And that's basically what it was. It's just like I hope I meet him, dude. I hope one day.
We could probably make that happen. All right, Joey Fats is here. 888-742-3345. His new music is called Farrakhan. You want to talk to us here? 888-742-3345. We got Rich on the line. That's a brand new one. It's called Farrakhan. I like that. Put that on my list. Giselle. All right. Rich, what up, man?
Rich, what's poppin'?
Yo, Rich.
What's going on, Fanny? What's up, Sweet?
What's up with you, man?
Hey.
Say what up to Joey Fats, man.
Yeah, what's up, Joey Fats, man?
Yo,
that's
good,
why
Rich?
I called, man. This like one of the realest, I mean, most heartfelt interviews I heard in like, I mean, like a long, 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 long time, man. I mean, like, this shit was great. I could feel everybody energy through the speakers. I'm all the way out in Florida, man. This shit sound like y'all sitting right next to me, man. This shit is like so positive, man, like for real, man. It really like put a smile on my face this morning.
Yeah, I appreciate it. You know what I mean? I'm glad that my struggle can make you smile, hopefully, and motivates you to be great at whatever you do. You know what I mean? The struggle,
man,
only temporary, homie.
Undoubtedly. It got to, man. That shit was amazing though, man. Like for real, man. It's like the feel good story of the year or something.
Yeah.
Like, it's a great interview,
yeah,
man.
I appreciate it, Rich. I appreciate it.
Next is Oprah. Hey, hey Rich, why don't you, he could get Farrakhan now too, right?
Yeah.
Hey, okay,
yeah,
want
yeah,
to
man, it was good. I like that too. I was turning my radio up but then listening through the phone, man. Two thumbs up, like, whoa.
Hey Rich, you a citizen, man.
Sway in the morning, homie.
All right, hey, man, get that song, man. We got, we're going to go to Sacktown. We got Big Rick on the line. What up, Big Rick?
Ricky.
What's up, Sway? Long time no hear from, man. I just like to thank you for helping Joy Crack out. And Joy Crack, that was an interesting story.
That's Joey Fats, man.
Joey Fats. But, yo, Rick, what's your name, bro?
Big Rick from Sacramento.
Yo, Big Rick, I got one question. You know who Mozzie is? You from Sacramento.
Mozzie?
Yeah.
Yeah, man, Mozzie's really with the shit, man.
There you go, that's what I'm talking about. Even though you call me Joey Crack, it's all good. You know who Mozzie is.
I apologize, man. My apologies, man.
It's all good, man.
But what you want to say, Big Rick? You got Joey Fats here.
I want to say I appreciate his effort. You know, I was homeless out there, too, and some people came and helped me out, and I got a one-bedroom apartment. I don't pay no rent now. I'm trying to get active in the business again.
Yeah.
That's what's up, man. Hey, pick up his music. Now that you got that apartment, you can download Farrakhan. That's
Def. All. You know what I mean? Bang it in there. And, you know what I mean? Do your little shuffle and all that.
Thank you, brother. We got Rocky from Chicago on the line. What up, Rocky?
Rocky!
What up, what up, what up?
Yeah,
man, I just want to go ahead and give praise to the man. I didn't even know who he was before listening to the interview, and I already started Googling while driving on the expressway with my niece. And, man, Buddy is the truth, man. And, you know, you don't hear too many so-called gangsters get on the radio and say, I'm burning hell for what I did out here in these streets. And Buddy did that, and that's the type of message we need to be sending to these kids when they're following these so-called men out here in these streets. I'm from Chicago, so, you know what I'm saying, you got a lot of kids following some false hopes out here, and when they get about 18, 19, they try to change their life, and it's too late. They got four felonies. So, you know what I'm saying? It's good to hear Buddy getting out here and teaching these young boys out here. And it ain't always about what you think it's about.
Yeah.
All right. His name Joey Fats, man. Check out his music. Download it for yourself and for your niece, man.
What you mean, Sway? I'm about to just increase my insurance bill trying to crash listen to this man and y'all right now. So I'm on it, man. You ain't got to tell me what.
All right, Rocky, you a citizen,
it's
mate.
Sway in the morning, Rock.
Okay, we're going to go to Mike. Mike, where you calling from, Mike?
Y'all from Carolina, man.
What up, Mike? Say what up to Mike, y'all.
Mike, what's poppin'?
Yo, ain't too much. Listen, bro, yo, I'm a fan of your shit now. Not even from the music yet, homie. But, like, just what you talking about, like, you know what I'm saying? I keep my kids fly and shit, you know what I'm saying? Because they're learning, they don't know no better. But it's so real out. None of this shit fucking matters, you know what I'm saying?
None of it matters, bro.
We ain't getting our minds right.
None of it matters, bro. None of it. You got to feed your mind. That vanity shit can be going today or be going tomorrow. You know what I mean? Like, just vanity, man.
Man. Hey, Mike, thanks for calling, man. Appreciate you. A citizen, too, man.
This way in the morning.
Oh, man. I didn't even make it's changed the whole trajectory of my day. My cousin Imani over there, she visiting from Oakland.
Great day to do that.
Yo, Cali up in here.
Imani, say what up, man. She's an attorney, by the way, if you need
work. I definitely need that work.
Okay, cool.
I got a lot of homies that need that work, too,
Imani, you trying to get this?
Imani just gave me the giggle curve. She just curved the shit out.
Oakland.
Joey, I'm curious about two things.
Yes.
The first one, going from homeless to being able to afford a car that's $90,000. What can you tell us and a lot of our listeners about money management? Like, what have you learned about what to do with money?
Money don't matter. I wouldn't care if I go broke tomorrow. Honestly, I don't care. That's what it's here for. It's meant to be spent. Like I said, I'm trying to give my mama something she never, you know, never experienced.
Right.
Like, the main reason why I got the store, like, I'm trying to bring a stable income off that store. I'm trying to give my mama a crib in Malibu. Like,
word.
That's what I got that for. Like, I put things in order to pay for other shit, you know what I mean? Like, so all the money I got is just really all profit. But, like, I'm not stupid. But like I said, like, I spend money, like, but it's not like on, like, this chain is old. Like, first of all, it's super old. Like, you know what I mean? Super old. And not only that, I only pay like $2,500 for it. Like, I did a couple shows. It wasn't like I paid for it out of my pocket.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So, like,
but you're paying your taxes and everything.
Yeah, everything's good. I'm a good businessman.
Okay.
Like, I pay attention to a lot of shit, but it's just like, it's dumb of me in a sense to do that, but I deserve it. I struggle. Yeah. I struggle for so long. Like, it's just like, not only that, how I look at it is, like, I got this 2015 car. I'm not going to be looking to buy a car for another 10 years. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So I'm going to get my money's worth out of it. So really, I'm paying like $9,000 for it a year. You know what I mean? Like, because I'm going to have it for 10 years. You know what I'm saying? So it's not like I'm just getting it to floss. Like, I don't even have pictures of it on Instagram. You know what I mean? Like, it's just like really just, I love Beamers. Like, driving in my old-ass, raggedy, shaking Camaro, seeing Beamers pass by. It was like, oh, I want one. And then, like, me being able to afford it, like, right, like, I'll be honest with you, like, me right now, I can't go pay $90,000 for it. But that's after I got off tour, when I came over here with Dizzy, right? I collect all my tour money. Mm-hmm. I pay for my tour myself, out of my pocket, my own cash, like, Sprinter bus, all that shit, you know what I mean? Like, but because I knew I was going to win, like, I was selling mad merch on tour. Everybody was loving the show. Like, after every show, I'm shaking every fan hand, thanks for coming out. So it's just like, it built me up to a point to where I was like, okay, it's 90,000, but it's going to make itself back, you know what I mean? Because, like, me being transparent and being with these people, like, you know what I mean, and growing in front of their eyes, they respect it a lot more. It's not like I'm flossing. It's more like he came from nothing. We can do this shit too. Right. You know what I mean? It's like that. It's not more like you don't see me. I don't even got videos in my shit. I don't burn rubber. I don't like. I'm not extra. You know what I mean? It's, I just love the car. Like I really just love the car. Like I'm talking about. I love everything about the car. I shine my wheels. Like I love the car. Like. It's that. Like, it's nothing like me.
You deserve to reward yourself.
Exactly. That's more what it's about.
And then the second thing, when you came in and you said you were listening earlier and we were having that conversation about gangbanging, and I wanted you to give us a little bit more of your insight into this, because I know the earlier years of your life, you were a part of that. And earlier today, we were talking about Chris Brown.
Yeah.
And how he was basically leading a tirade against one of his former friends, mm-hmm. Kevin McCall, who he's collaborated with. And in this long-ass post he put on Instagram, he mentioned Pyru. Mm-hmm. And this isn't the first time that we've heard him say this. And I'm wondering if it's okay for artists to kind of shout out, you know what I mean, a set if they're not fully in
it. They putting their life in danger. Mm. Except them, if they think it's a game. Like when I, like, if you listen to my project, like you listen to the first song, I talk about me being blackballed in the industry because I was that guy. Like when I first got on, like me being such a street guy, I didn't take nothing from nobody. You know what I mean? Like mm-hmm. I actually thought they were serious. These people was big blood and, you know what I mean? And one of the situations I got into, a rapper from LA, big blood and, you know what I mean? I'm thinking he with the shit to where I'm thinking like, oh, he wants something to do with me. I got to protect myself. So I immediately see him. I'm in action. Like I'm on my street shit immediately. Like he screamed like a girl. Like I never heard a man scream like that in my life. Like literally screamed, hiding behind his car door, and I laughed. I literally laughed and just was like, "Am I really
too real?
Yeah, like like am I really like
too real?
Like, it's just like it, like the game is like these niggas don't really bang. These niggas like my mama is an OG. Like that's why Waka loved me so much because my mama is an OG from his hood. Waka big homie Madball is my mama's little homie. You know what I mean? Like my mama is an OG from Elm Street. You know what I mean? Like, and that's why he loved me because we had just a lot of shit in common. And like just like that's why I wanted to game bang. Just hearing the stories of my mama, like you know what I mean, how she had the sisterhood with her sisters. You know what I mean? Like, and just like I like my auntie would tell me stories about my mama going to Davis, taking an AK, no Uzi. Matter of fact, my bad. Don't quote me on that. Uzi. Okay. You know what I mean? And her backpack to Davis, jumping the back fence. You know what I mean? Just to go to school because she's the only Pyru in that area. You dig what I'm saying? It's all T flats. That was that was a Mexican neighborhood right there. So she had to protect herself. You know what I mean? That's my auntie telling me that. You know what I mean? Like my mama got stab wounds in her stomach. My mom been through the most. You know what I mean? It's just like my mom was not even a woman. Like how can I be a bitch? Like I can't do that. Like my mom was not even like how can I be soft? Like you know what I mean? Like she's not even looking for mercy or nothing like that. Like so how can I be, you know, complaining? That's just how I looked at just being homeless too. You know what I mean? Just like. My mama slept in garages and all that shit to make sure we was all right. You know what I mean? Like, anything she did, I can do it too. You know what I mean? Like, that's my queen right there. You know what I mean? So it's just like.
Generational. Yeah. And Vince was saying the same thing. And that's when I see, I feel almost sorry for some of these artists that ain't really from that and claim that. But you said it. The realest thing ever is, man, they want to do that. They putting their lives in jeopardy.
Yeah, like I said, I'm not proud of nothing I did. It's not nothing I go back. It's not like what I did in the streets. I'm not going to be telling my kids about this shit. Like, it's not like, that's not nothing I want to glorify. You know what I mean? Like, I did it in the music because that's what I was seeing. You know what I mean? At the time, like, I was facing indictments when I first dropped my first mixtape. Like, me and Vince is under investigation. Like, my little brother's in jail right now for the shit. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like they basically was trying to GS9 us before Bobby Smurda, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So it's just like, that's how they was trying to do us, you know what I mean? But that's what made me wise up and really see what I was up against, you know what I mean? And just knowing, like noticing like how much power I had. You know, it's a reason why these people want me behind bars because they think I'm doing something, you know what I mean? It's just like, I had a voice. And it's just like now, since I've been away, that's why I ain't dropped nothing for a year. I was just reading and educating myself.
It's been
myself.
A while, man. Yeah,
I was trying to educate myself. So it's just like, the rapper's cool, you know what I mean? But who wants to be a rapper? I don't look up to no rappers. I don't look up to nothing. Because the rapping is like, it's a costume. Mm-hmm. You looking up to a character. Mm-hmm. It's fake. You might as well go look up to Bugs Bunny or some shit. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, I look up to people like Elon Musk, Mark Zuckerberg, you know what I mean? Like, people who made living better, you know what I mean? Like environmental people. Like, it's deeper than rap to me, you know what I mean? Like, I'm trying to, like, start a Fortune 500 company type shit, you know what I mean? Be a dollar a year salary man, you know what I mean? Like, trying to make that much money, but not really make it, give it to charities and good shit like that.
Joey Fast, okay. Man. Yeah, man. the new project, man. I can't wait to hear the, I mean, talk about the project, man.
Well, the project is called I Call You Tomorrow. It's really like, it's funny, it's fun, but really it's really about the whole like Yams thing, what happened, like, I like, me not dropping nothing for a year, that's basically what was going on in my whole life. Like, yo, I'll talk to you later type shit. Like, I'm just going through so much shit right now. Like, I can't, you know what I mean? I can't deal with it right now. I was, like, not calling my mama. Like, I wasn't talking to my mom for months at a time. It just was to, like, I felt like I couldn't come around her unless I was benefiting her. You know what I mean? Mm. It's like, I couldn't see my mama face and just be like, hey, ma. You know what I mean? And knowing that she was going through what she was going through and not being able to show up. Like, it's the best shit ever. Like, I just got a check from, like, iTunes, like, a couple weeks ago. And, like, my mom just called me randomly, right? So I'm like, yo, mom, what you doing? And she's like, I'm not doing nothing. I'm out here bored, baby. So I'm like, you need to come see me. So, like, she don't know what I'm telling her to come see me for. She show up. I just handed her $1,000. Like, you know what I mean? Like, she's like, oh, baby, thank you. You know, she's all happy, even though it's not, like, a lot of money. She's, like, super, like, she wasn't expecting it. But just being able to do shit like that, you know what I mean? Like, that's what it's about, bro. That's what I mean. Like, I don't care about going broke. Like, I would deplete my account right now if something was to go on with, like, my mama or something. Like, because that's what it's about. Like, I don't even plan on being in America after my mom going to heaven. You know what I mean? This is not even the place to be. You dig what I'm saying? I'm just here for my mom. Like, my mama got felonies. She can't leave. She can't leave the country. Yeah. Like, so it's just like this shit. Yeah. It's a bigger picture to me. I did a lot of reading being away.
I feel it. Mm-hmm. I feel it. Joey Fats. Ooh, I like this, man. I almost want to say, man, you ain't even got to spit bars this morning, man, because you've been spitting
so much truth.
You've been spitting so many bars.
Yo, you gonna give me the pass?
I wasn't gonna say that.
I forgot he
rapped.
I ain't ask no questions. Nigga, you gotta give me something before you leave. Shit, you gave Sway all that. You told Tracy, but that's my love right here.
You know I got you.
Joey Fats, ladies and gentlemen, Sway in the Morning, Shade 4 or 5. Hey, man, you be the second MC to spit in this new studio since we've been on air, man.
Oh, I love these walls and all that shit.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah.
Sway in the Morning, Shade 4 or 5, real spit only.
Yeah, I'm feeling I'm home. My block, I roam a pocket full of stones and a nickel plated 9. I'm feeling I'm home, always travel alone. And I dare nigga try to take mine, a nigga on Sway. Strapped up like a dyke bitch. Take a pussy nigga ice quick, that's light shit. Yeah, cause these guns ain't for show, boy. 40 shoot his face out his fro, boy. I'm letting niggas know, boy, that this 2 in crip. Yeah, you know my name, nigga, you know my gang. And if you got a problem, you know I serve my cane. On the one way, if you come, make sure you come with your thing. I'm not with the games, okay, switch subjects. I'm ballin' hard, these bitches love it. I just fuck them, then fuck it, I gotta get this money. Rob a nigga for his cash and pay my tithes on Sunday. Lord, should I be worried about karma? If I'm robbing shit but giving you my dollars. Neck too black for these white collars. So when I applied, these motherfuckers gave me problems. And the farthest that I got was the stock room. Screaming, fuck my boss, gonna be on soon. Same nigga used to slang weed in homeroom. Hustle hard cause I didn't have a home to go home to. So tell me what I gotta lose, nigga. I'm on the block with my niggas that's down to pop a few hiccups. So come up out them fucking Jews, nigga. Every play we.
Yo, Wonder, I fell off about that, yo.
Nah. Hey, we felt like we was in the movie theater right there, man. Yeah. Oh.
His neck was too black for white collars.
You know, I'm home, Sway.
Come on.
Did you wanna keep going?
Come on.
Let me get the beat again.
Oh, what? Yep. Got to, man, but I was satisfied right there. I just want to know what you want to do, Joey Fast. Sway in the Morning, Shade 4 or 5. This is the annihilation of whack rappers right now. It's taking place at the beat.
I love it.
Truth Serum. Hashtag Truth Serum.
Yeah, it's only a few niggas that'll bust, a few niggas that I trust. So every time a nigga ride, I keep my 45 tucked. Diamond to fine dime, we high blowing ganja. Neck in my watch shine, but still ain't got the time, bruh. Cause it ain't about money, you see. Cause when I was broke, all you niggas weren't fucking with me. I die for what I own before a nigga take something from me. I did a lot of shit, so I know karma coming for me. Karma, how you doing? My name is Joey, I like to blow trees from the east side of Long Beach. I like to hang out with my OGs, late drinking 40s, making music now, so all the ops know me. Still I'm TTG, leaving niggas holy. Karma, I heard about you. You tryna fuck, I'm tryna fuck you too. You be fucking everybody, girl, but I don't give a fuck tonight. I got my hammer tucked tonight. Let a op try to drive by, I'ma leave him like Harold at that light. The enemy shot the block up the other day. Like Nipsey said, gang bang, do it right. Ran up on him in the morning while he eat eggs. Came back and smoked his older brother the same night. Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah.
All right. Damn. That might have been the hardest shit I heard ever.
Pull out.
Damn. Roll up,
Yo, Joey Fats, man. You the truth, homie.
Nah, you the truth. I appreciate
man,
you.
Man, nah, it's all love, man. Let's just keep sharpening this steel together.
Always. All
right?
You already know
okay,
what it is.
We're going to build.
Yo, you want to know what? Since I'm transparent.
Yeah.
Okay, standing up.
Okay, so, you know, holidays pass, New Year's.
Yeah.
You know, I try to text my buddy, right?
Yeah.
And I got a red arrow, meaning that he changed his number. I wouldn't happen to think this man is sitting next to me, but... Yeah, Sway, I'm talking about you.
Oh, hold up, man. Let me see if that's true or not. Let me check my text messages. Yo. Okay, hold up. Let me see. Well, let me pull up your info. Hold up. Oh, well, hold up.
I got a new number.
You got a new number?
Yeah, you know, bro, okay. The shorties be blowing me up. I got to change it up sometimes.
It's no longer that?
Nope, let me get it for you.
Okay, see, so who you texting?
Exactly, that's what I'm saying, though.
Okay.
That's what I'm saying, though. I just had to put you on blast.
Okay, I appreciate that, man. Thank you. Hey, but you know, during the holiday, I actually went to the islands.
That was why then. That was why. Because it was more like, it was the Red Arrow saying that it wasn't delivered. You probably just didn't have no service.
Yeah, I didn't have no service. Yeah. I was on Turks and Caicos.
You ain't got to explain myself.
I want
to
be transparent.
You ain't got to explain yourself. You been rude to me day one.
You know, man. You know,
you know I just got to make you feel uncomfortable sometimes.
And I appreciate that, but let me finish my stunt right. Button. You know, we had rented a house on the beach. And, I'm sorry if I didn't get the...
Oh, word?
Yeah, next time I'll invite you, homie. Come hang with
that's
me.
That's how you doing it, huh?
It's a fun time.
And you calling me your buddy, goddamn.
Yeah, you my brother, man.
Oh, goddamn.
You done graduated. All
God
that realness.
Damn. Okay,
I just texted you my thing again.
Got
okay.
You, big dog.
All right.
It's most likely the number I got.
Check it. So, you going on tour?
Yeah, I got a tour in May.
Okay.
May, my own headlining tour.
Wow.
Paid for by Joey Fats once again.
Okay, when you come back to New York, let us know, man.
Got
we're going to make
dog.
Sure we
you
come check
know,
that
I got
out.
You.
And then before you leave, man, let's go grab some food or something.
Definitely, on me. On me.
I was going to say it, but
on me. You heard?
I eat at Del Frisco's, Joey.
He don't want that 32 pounds.
I got you. I got
you. Eating at McDonald's when you was in that Camaro, but we ain't doing that right now.
Yeah, we ain't doing that. We ain't doing that. We get new offices and new and all that.
Yeah, man. You see, we got them flipping the offices, man.
Man, this shit crazy.
Nah, man. But listen, the man, your story is very inspirational, man.
Yeah.
And these moments remind me of what is good about. I've had my struggles with the music business based on what you were saying.
Yeah.
A lot of these artists be characters.
Yeah.
You
That's all it is.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I mean? Like, but like that's why like when I met you, like, you know what I mean? Like knowing who you are.
Mm-hmm.
I just off the back like I didn't tell you not a lie from who I was, mm-hmm. what I was representing, none of that. You know what I mean? I just felt like I gotta lay it on the table with this dude. You mm-hmm. know what I mean? Because I think he's gonna respect that so much. He's seen so many characters come and go
mm-hmm.
that if I just be this real dude, I don't give a fuck if I'm not, you know, ASAP Rocky or bigger. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? He's gonna respect it. You know what I mean? That's basically what it is.
That's
you know what
that's exactly mm-hmm. what it is because mm-hmm. I've seen a whole lot.
Yeah.
You know, but. You important. You important to this generation.
Appreciate
you know,
it.
You important to my generation.
Appreciate it.
Okay, because you may learn something inspired by me, but I'm learning something inspired by you.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Even playing field when it comes to that. So I respect you on that level. Joey Fats, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, give out your social media so they can hit you, bro.
At Joey Fats, at JoeyFats on every goddamn thing.
All right.
Fuck with me.
And we're going to post this interview tomorrow, man, and spread the word, man.
Spread the
word.
Goddamn word.
It's Sway in the morning, only on Shea 45.